Hello everyone, today we're going to see how to remove a Google account for minors from a Pixel or Android device. I'd like to remind you that Google provides accounts for minors that can be managed by parents through the Family Link app, allowing them to set limits on content, screen time, and more for children to prevent them from overusing multimedia devices. I need to format the Pixel 5 that my daughter was using because we traded it in on the Google store for a Pixel 9a that my wife got. So we need to delete all the data from the Pixel 5. Anyone who's a bit familiar with Android would immediately go to settings. I have my devices set to English simply to make multilingual videos, so I'll explain every step I take out loud anyway. So let's go into system. At the bottom, the last setting is reset options. Again, at the bottom, you'll find errors, all data, factory reset. As you can see, it's grayed out. A child cannot independently format or reset a device that contains an account managed by a parent. So that's a dead end. We cannot format from the device. How should we format the device? Some parents end up on Google support communities with endless problems, or they've completely deleted the account, or somehow formatted the smartphone without removing the child's account. All these messes can end up blocking everything. By going to the family center that Google provides for support, it's explained very simply how to remove the account, which I remind you will remain active and can still be used on a new device or a tablet. So how do we remove it? It's simple. We need to go into Family Link. So a parent's authorization is required. Family Link, a brief overview. At the top left, you can switch between your children. In my case, I have two. All the options. What we're interested in is the last option at the bottom. I'm in the central tab, you can see the controls, right? Go to the controls tab and select the child. The last item at the bottom, let's check the devices where my daughter's account is present. Here they are. Google Pixel 5, which is the one from which we need to remove the account. Lenovo tablet, Pixel 8, which is her current smartphone, and a Chromebook where she sometimes does her homework. So we need to reset the Pixel 5. Let's go inside. Here, there are a series of settings, but in our case, we won't look at them now. Maybe I'll do a separate focus on Family Link later because it's a very important topic. At the bottom, as you can see, there's an option in red, precisely to make us understand that this is a delicate and irreversible operation that allows us to reset the device and delete all data, okay? So the Pixel 5 will be reset and there will be nothing left of my daughter's data. Let's go over once again what to check before resetting devices. In the Android settings under system, let's go check backup. Let's make sure that the backup has been completed. In our case, it was done on Google One since I have a paid plan that my whole family can use, but everyone can do backups, okay? Even those with a free account. So before resetting, we make sure that the backup has been completed. And another thing we need to check is that Google Photos backup is also enabled. I won't go into it so as not to show you photos of my daughter, but you need to enable automatic synchronization in Google Photos so that all the child's photos on the device will be saved to the Google account, and then through Google Photos, we'll find them on the new device. I'd like to remind you that the full backup on Android and Pixel basically does not backup only the photos, okay? So the Android backup covers all data except for photos, precisely because photos are managed through synchronization by Google Photos. So we've made sure we've done the backup, we've made sure the photos have been saved, Family Link is on the parent's device. Now let's go ahead and reset and format. Now it asks us which of the two scenarios we are in. So the device has been lost, misplaced, or stolen. And in this case, there will be a procedure that will first guide us to try to find it, to try to locate where it is. In our case, we need to reset it for other reasons, specifically because we need to sell it. We choose the second option. Here, Google notifies us that after we remove this child account from the Pixel 5, any account can be added to the Pixel 5. Why does it remind us of this? Because if we remove the Google account from a smartphone incorrectly, using an improper procedure, the smartphone activates factory reset protection. And when we format and restart it, the first thing it will ask for is the account that was present on the device when it was formatted. Only after entering that account will we actually be able to restore the device. Let's actually proceed with the reset as well, because as I mentioned, we need to send the Pixel 5 to Google. We tap next on family link. Now we are presented with a series of warnings. It tells us what will be deleted, the Google account, parental control apps, photos, applications, music, and everything else. It also asks if we want to disable theft protection. Yes, we need to disable it because our device hasn't been stolen. We don't want to activate any security system since we have to format it and basically sell it to a third party who shouldn't encounter any issues. We tap reset device. Of course, both devices need to be connected to the internet. In fact, the reset command will be sent to the Pixel 5. It doesn't seem to be reaching the device. Let's turn off Do Not Disturb for a moment. Maybe a notification will come through. Honestly, I don't remember. Here we go. The notification has arrived, as you saw. Nothing needed to be done. It was just a warning notification, and the reset of the Pixel 5 has started. I'll just take a few more seconds of your time to show you the completed procedure. If you don't mind waiting just a moment. Here it is now restarting. It's erasing all the data. Basically, we're done. When the process is finished, we'll have the Pixel 5 as good as new, just like it came from the factory, and ready to welcome a new account. I think with that, I can say goodbye. I remind you that there will be another video about the trading process for this Pixel 5, because I'll also show you the packaging used to send it back to Google, how to pack it, the instructions, and everything else to avoid any mistakes. Since I remind you that you pay for the Pixel upfront and then the refund is processed after Google receives the device. So if it gets damaged or anything like that, we lose money. Okay? In the next few days, that other video will be released as well. As always, thank you. And I remind you to subscribe to my channel to get all the most important news about Google, its services, and its products, especially the Pixel devices, which I'm in love with. Leave a like. Recommend me to your friends, and in the meantime, let me show you that the Pixel is ready to be reconfigured. As you can see, no lock has been activated, so we can reconfigure it for someone else, for a child, or in my case, send it back to Google for the trade-in. Bye. Best regards to everyone from Antonio Camerino.